Peace, peace, peace. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. I got another video for y'all. This is a music reflection. This song is G Herbo Crazy. It's from, I don't know if it's a mixtape or album, strictly from my fans. We're gonna get right into it.
G Herbo.
Sorry, bro. I'm a beast, man. You know, I'm just doing me. I can't complain.
A product of my environment, of course I am. Walking with this torch, I am. Still smell like gunpowder. Straight up off that porch, I am. Youngest nigga got up on his grizzly without force, I am. Going cop that new Ferrari, 700 horse, I am. And I told my big bro, let me see you run it up. I don't give a motherfuck about them if they ain't one of us. Niggas, they ain't nothing like us. They want on that block like us. They don't tote them block like us. They won't die for rock like us. Understand it, overhand it. Get that money, rubber band it. Count it first before you spend it. I don't think they comprehend it. Thinking about my big bro, Crazy Jay. He got apprehended. All we know is block, block, block. Then the coppers had him. Can't forget my bro to roll. I love him like my mama had him. That night we lost Toby on the 8th block. Had that Glock beside him. Can't forget about them days and nights. Cause they made it. We survived the trenches. We was crazy.
Yeah, he said a few things in just that first verse, right? He was just talking about like a product of my environment. Of course I am. You know, I'm walking with this torch, I am. Like, you know, still smell like gunpowder. Straight off the porch, I am. And this becomes the reality for a lot of young men living in the hood. Like, a product of the environment. Like, when your environment is chaotic and it's crazy, and you're seeing people get killed, and you're seeing things happen to people, a lot of times, you start telling yourself, like, that ain't gonna be me. And you gotta get guns. Like, and I said this before in some of my videos, like, I used to like to fight. I used to like to beat people up. But when people started shooting at me, when people didn't want to fight, or people was, not that I was some big tyrant, but it's like people used to start shit because maybe they knew they had guns or they had access to them. I didn't know nobody with no guns. I didn't have access to guns. So I just used to work out and beat people up, right? And when these people started shooting at you, you got to make decisions that sometimes you might not really want to make, but you got to make statements and you got to hold your ground. So a lot of people get off the porch and whatever your mama taught you in the house, the streets is a whole different ballgame. It's a whole different field. And you got to do what you got to do to survive and make it home. And a lot of times our parents don't even understand that stuff. And then he said at the end of this, he was just talking about, you know, then he broke down, like, you know, what they was doing and how they were selling drugs and whatever. Just kind of like doing things to survive, right, in the neighborhood. Especially when you're young and you can't see nothing else. And then he said, yo, we was crazy. And I think that there's a lot of people who talk about it and try to glorify it and be cute about it and you know, try to act, try to play the persona of a tough guy. But like, yo, the real tough dudes, they either become crazy or they was already crazy some way, somehow. But I mean, they become crazy because of the environment, because it's not just anybody that's doing certain things in the hood, man. Like getting in the car and driving past and shooting at a crowd, like, that shit is not really crazy. Like, it's crazy what you did, but that doesn't make you like some crazy dude. Like there's stories about dudes like getting out the car, 16 shots in the head, like crazy shit. That shit is crazy and graphic. So yeah, let's go back.
Lonely, I was hungry, almost drove me crazy. Walked out the house and got right in the streets. That shit was crazy. Bullets flying right in front of me. That shit was crazy. Shooters diving right in front of me. My niggas crazy. Don't know how, but I made it home. Shit was crazy. Out, then eventually I just start going crazy. When I say I don't give a fuck, they think I'm crazy. Don't blame me, I'm just a product of what made you supposed.
See, like, he breaking down, like I resonate with this, cause I just be thinking about that sometimes. I be thinking about all the gunplay that we had. Like, we literally used to have like gun drama like every week. I think about all the beefs we had, like how many people could have lost their lives. I just be thinking about that, and I be like, yo, we was crazy. So when I hear him say some of these things, I'm not even gonna say that it was maybe the same. Like, it's just like, damn. Like, I be like, yo, we was crazy. So when I hear him say those things, I resonate with them. And when he talks about hungry nights and hungry moments and trying to figure out how to eat, he don't know how he made it home. That shit was crazy. Like, just recollecting on certain things, man. Yeah.
On that that corner. It was after midnight on a school night. 30 clip right on us. Lord, I promise I'm just trying to do right. Tell me how you grew up. It's my story. Let me hear what you like. But it was in middle school. He just trying to protect his new bike. Now I live the president. I might go protect with blue light. I might go bit Frank the Mueller. Make you work, curse out your jeweler. Golden links like Rick the Ruler. In your club might be able to roll up. Walk inside with sticks and rulers. Oh shit, be so quick to do you. Anyway, I've been straight in since a teen. Literally, fuck shit up. Walk out, tell them bill me. Hillary, you starving. We eating over here, B. Get a piece, close mouth, don't get fed. You a pussy, don't come near the G. And they say I'm crazy. Me, I say I'm crazy. Mom, pops at home. The street lights, that's who raised me. The streets, they love me one day. And the next, I know they hate me. I love what I become. I'm just a product of what made me.
Yeah, like, and I think, like, this is, like, a lot of people go through this, but a lot of people don't get rich, like Herbo, right? A lot of people don't make it out of this, so I feel like the individuals that do make it, they recollecting, they're talking about what they've been through, they talking about those hungry nights, those nights they didn't know they was going to survive, how they was going to make it home, and now they're in this place, and they're looking back like, damn, it was crazy. And again, yes, the music is, yeah, we, whatever, we're not getting into that whole thing. I'm just showing y'all how, like, some people be talking about some of these things, right? And they just be reflecting, and they just be in a place. It's almost like they're grateful where they at today because they came from something. You know, G Herbo also recently, I think he opened up, like, he donated something to open up some center in Chicago, I believe, to kind of, like, help, like, troubled youth. So that's the kind of things we like to see, right? Lil Durk also did the same thing. So I don't really agree with the shit that they be saying in some of the songs. But he sounds like, in this song, he's talking about his experience, you know. And I think, like, that's all we have, our experiences, where we came from and what we doing now.
Lonely, I was hungry, almost drove me crazy. Walked out the house and got right in the streets. That shit was crazy. Bullets flying right in front of me. That shit was crazy. Shooters diving right in front of me. My niggas crazy. Don't know how, but I made it home. Shit was crazy. Out then eventually I just start going crazy. When I say y'all don't give a fuck, they think I'm crazy. Don't blame me, I'm just a product of what made me. Almost drove me crazy.
So one of the things he said in that chorus, he said they turned me out and I just started going crazy. And I think that's something that happens to a lot of people in the hood. And I made a video about niggas and black people, right? And I think that a lot of black people, they pick up arms at some point because they realize what the niggas is doing in the community and they just trying to survive. So like Herbo said, right, he said, like, you know, he was young, like he hopped off straight off the porch. There's a lot of kids that are 12, 13, straight off the porch into the field, right? Playing grown man games. They're getting locked up for homicides. They're getting locked up in indictments. They're getting locked up for a whole bunch of stuff that they have no idea what the repercussions of this is. They don't know. They're young. So I just wanted to highlight when he said that they turned him out. Kind of like the same way these young girls get turned out to be sexually super sexualized and hypersexual. Guys get turned out to this life of gang violence and this life of drug dealing and this life of, so it's like both of our youth are getting turned out to something. The women are getting turned out to sex. The men are getting turned out to hustling and violence and gun drama and stuff like that. So I like how he kind of like was just reflecting, like, you know, it turned me out. And he said, like, I was going crazy. Like, it's people like that, right? Sometimes people don't know how they're going to make it through. But, you know, shout outs to Herb. Hopefully he's doing the right thing, whatever the right thing is for him. You know, he got a family. And it seems like he be trying to do little things to try to, like, help his community back out. But let me know what y'all thoughts are in the comment section. Like, comment, subscribe, share. Stay blessed. Peace.